Good morning students, welcome back to Max class. Let us continue with the exercise. 20th question. The question is, in a potato race, a bucket is placed at the starting point, which is 5 meter from the first potato, and the other potatoes are placed 3 meter apart in a straight line. There are 10 potatoes in the line. A competitor starts from the bucket, picks up the nearest potato, runs back with it, drops it in the bucket, runs back to pick the next potato, runs to the bucket to drop it in, and she continues in the same way until all the potatoes are in the bucket. What is the total distance the competitor has to run? So here I draw the diagram. This is the bucket. There are 10 potatoes in a line, and the first potato is 5 meters away from the bucket. The competitor will start from the bucket, will reach the first potato, pick up the potato and drop it in it, then go back to the next potato, then will come back and it will be continuing. Totally 10 potatoes he has to drop it in the bucket. So how to write the AP? First, the competitor will start from the bucket. The first potato is 5 meter away from the bucket. So how much distance he has to travel? So from the bucket to the first potato, it is 5 meter. She will start from the bucket, runs, pick the potato, comes back, drop the potato in the bucket. So here 5 meter, coming back again 5 meter. Total distance traveled is 2 into 5. So first I'll write 2 into 5. Again from the bucket, from here the competitor will start, runs to the second potato. So here 5 meter plus 3 meter. So what is the distance traveled by the girl? 8 meter. Again comes back and drop the potato. So 5 plus 3, 8. So 2 into 5 plus 3. Why this is 2 into? Because going and coming back. In the same way, next is from the bucket, she will travel to the next third potato she will reach. So 5 plus 3 plus 3. So 2 times. So 2 into 5 plus 3 plus 3. It will continue like this. So we will write the AP. 2 into 5 is 10. 2 into 8. It is 16. Again 5 plus 3, 8 plus 3, 11. 2 into 11, 22. A equals 10. D equals A2 minus A1. 16 minus 10. It is 6. There are 10 potatoes. So 10 times she will travel. So n is equal to 10. We wanted to find out how much distance the competitor has to run. So Sn we have to find out. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. S10 equals 10 by 2 into 2 into 10 plus 10 minus 1 into 6. It is 5 into 20 plus 9 into 6. 5 into 20 plus 54. So it is 5 into 74. So 370. So the total distance run by the competitor is 370 meter. This is the last question in the chapter. Now we'll see some additional questions from AP. First question is, find the sum of first 10 natural numbers. What is the formula for finding the sum of natural numbers? Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. There are 10 natural numbers. So we are finding the sum of 10 natural numbers. S10 is equal to 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2. That is equal to 10 into 11 by 2. Cancel 55. So sum of first 10 natural numbers is 55. Whenever we wanted to find out the sum of first n natural numbers, continuous natural numbers, we can use the formula Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. The next question is, find the sum of first 111 terms of an AP whose 56th term is 5 by 37. We have to find the sum of 111 terms AP whose 56th term is 5 by 37. AP is not given, only the 56th term is given. D also we don't know. So from this only we have to find out the sum. Sum of 111 terms we have to find out. Given that the 56th term, so A 56 is equal to 5 by 37. How can we expand A 56? It is A plus 55D. A plus 55D is equal to 5 by 37. We will leave it like this. Now we will write the formula for SN. We know SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. We wanted to find out sum of 111 terms. So N become 111 instead of N, 1 by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1, 111 minus 1 into D is equal to 111 by 2 into 2A plus 110D. So here what we have to do is inside the bracket it is 2A plus 110D will take 2 common from both the numbers. When you take 2 outside, the remaining terms are A plus 2 into A, 2A, 2 into which number is 110, it is 55D. So we have taken 2 from 2A and 110D. This 2 and 2 will cancel. 111 into, instead of A plus 55D, we have the value A plus 55D is 5 by 37. A plus 55D is nothing but A 56. Cancel, 37, 3s are 111. So 3 into 5, 50. Sum of 111 terms in this AP is 50. Next question is, find the sum of all the natural numbers between 200 and 300 which are exactly divisible by 6. Find the sum of all the natural numbers between 200 and 300 which are divisible by 6. So between 200 and 300 which are the natural numbers divisible by 6, let us check first. To find the first number, as I told you, we will divide 200 by 6. 6 threes are 18, remainder 2, 20. Again 6 threes are 18, remainder 2. We have to subtract 6 minus 2, it is 4. 200 plus 4, 204. So the first number is 204. To get the next number, it is divisible by 6, just add 6. So 210, 216, etc. To find the last number between 200 and 300, that is a question. So even though 300 is divisible by 6, we cannot include 300 here because we want the numbers which are divisible between 200 and 300. So which will be the previous number? Previous number we can find out by directly subtracting 6. To get the next number, we will add the common difference. To get the previous number, we can subtract common difference. So 300 minus 6 is 294 is the nth term or AN. So here A is 204, D directly we can write 6, AN is 294. We want to find out the sum of the natural numbers, but N we don't have, so we have to find out first N. To find N, we will use AN formula. AN equals A plus N minus 1 into D. 294 equals 204 plus N minus 1 into 6. 294 minus 204 is equal to 6N minus 6. So here when you subtract, we will get 90. 90 is equal to 6N minus 6. 90 plus 6 is equal to 6N. 6N equals 96. N equals 96 by 6. Cancel. 6 are 36. N is 16. So we want to find out sum. SN equals, we'll use the second formula, N by 2 into A plus AN is equal to S16 equals 16 by 2 into A is 204 plus AN is 294. 16 and 2 cancel. 8. We'll add it. How much will it? 8, 9, 498. Multiply. 3, 9, 8. So sum of first 16 terms which are divisible by 6 between 200 and 300 is 3984. The next question is, find 3 numbers in an AP whose sum is 24 and their product is 480. It's a different question, an important question. To sum is 24, product is 480, 3 numbers are in AP, we have to find the numbers. So normally when we write 3 numbers, we will write first term is A, second term is A plus D and third term is A plus 2D we will take. Normally first 3 terms of the AP. But if we take like this, it will be, the sum will be very lengthy. I'll just show you. So sum will be 24, we will write A plus D plus A plus 2D is equal to 24. We'll add all the A's, 3A plus 3D is equal to 24. If we cancel throughout by 3, we'll get A plus D is equal to 8, one equation we will get. Again, when we go for the product, A into A plus D into A plus 2D is equal to 480. When you expand and do A into A into A, we will get A cube. It will become very difficult to do this sum. So, I will do in a different method, the sum in an easy way. So, what we have to do is, we will consider the 3 terms of the AP or 3 numbers of this AP as first term is A and second term is AP. To get the next term, we will add the common difference. To get the previous term, what we have to do? We have to subtract the common difference. So, what is the previous term of A? It will be A minus D. So, in this question, whenever sum of 3 numbers and product is given, 3 numbers of the AP can be taken as, instead of A, A plus D, A plus 2D, we can take A minus D, A and A plus D. And these are the 3 numbers. Now we will go, sum is 24. So we will write, sum means plus symbol, we will write, first term plus, second term plus, third term is equal to 24. Sum equals 24. Minus D and plus D will cancel. A plus A is 3A. 3A equals 24 and A equals 24 by 3, we'll get 8. Directly we'll get the value of 8. Now we'll consider the product. Product of these 3 numbers is 480. We'll write A minus D into A plus D is equal to 480. As it is a binomial, put the bracket. Now first we'll write the single letter A. Now we'll write these two brackets together, A minus D into A plus D is equal to 480. As you all know, A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So A plus D into A minus B is A square minus D square. A into A square minus B square equals 480. Now we'll substitute the value of A, 8 into 8 square minus D square is equal to 480. 8 square is 64 minus D square is equal to 480 by 8. We'll divide this 4. If you want, you can multiply. But if you multiply, multiply with both the terms. So better you will divide it. 64 minus D square equals 8 here. 8, 6 are 48. 60 we will get. 64 minus 60 is equal to D square. D square equals 4, D equals square root of 4 is equal to 2. So we have A value and D. Now we will find the 3 numbers. First number is A minus D. A is 8, 8 minus 2, 6. Next term is A, it is 8. Third term is A plus D is equal to 8 plus 2. So I think you understood this sum. So whenever sum and product, especially if sum and product is given, we have to take the 3 terms of the AP as A minus D, A and A plus D. And last, when you find the numbers, don't forget to write A minus D, A, A plus D. Don't write A, A plus D, A plus 2D, because normally we will write A, A plus D, A plus 2D. So it's a very important question for 3 mark. The next question is, find 3 numbers in an AP whose sum is 80 and product of their extreme is 32. Here also sum is 18, product of the extremes is 32. So whenever sum and product comes, the 3 numbers are A minus D, A and A plus D. So first we will write sum is 80. Sum, we have to write the plus symbol. A plus D is equal to 18. Minus D and plus D will cancel. 3A equals 18. A equals 18 by 3, 6. Now, product of the extremes. Extreme means the n terms. So we have three terms in that which are the n terms, starting and ending terms. So that is A minus D and A plus D. Product is A minus D into A plus D. Product of the extremes is 32. So A plus D into A minus D is A square minus D square equals 32. Substitute the value of A. 6 square minus D square equals 32. 36 minus D square equals 32. 36 minus 32 is equal to D square. D square equals 4. D equals square root of 4, 2. Now, the three numbers are A minus D, 6 minus 2, 4. A is 6 and A plus D is 6 plus 2, 8. If you want to verify your answer, sum of the three numbers is 18. We'll add and see. 6 plus 4, 10 plus 8, 18. Product of the extremes is 32. Extremes are A minus D and A plus D. That is 4 and 8. 4 into 8, 32. So the three numbers are 4, 6 and 8. The next question is, find three numbers in an EP whose sum is 15 and sum of the square of their extreme is 58. So we'll start as it is. Three numbers are A minus D, A and A plus D. Sum is 15. So A minus D plus A plus A plus D is equal to 15. Minus D and plus D will cancel. 3A equals 15. A equals 15 by 3, 5. Now, sum of the square of their extremes. The extreme terms are A minus D and A plus D. Sum. Sum means first we will write plus symbol. Square of their extreme. So, first term square plus last term square is 58. So, here we will use the formula A minus B the whole square formula. It is A square minus 2AD plus B square. Instead of B, we have to write D. Again, A plus B the whole square. A square plus 2AD plus D square is equal to 58. Sum of the square of their extremes. Minus 2AD and plus 2AD will cancel. A square plus A square is 2A square. D square plus D square is 2D square equals 58. Substitute the value of A. 2 into 5 square plus 2D square equals 58. 5 square is 25. 25 into 2, 50. 50 plus 2D square equals 58. 2D square equals 58 minus 50. It is 8. D square equals 8 by 2, 4. D equals square root of 4, 2. Therefore, the three terms are A minus D. A is 5. So, 5 minus 2, 3. A, 5. A plus D. It is 5 plus 2, 7. Next question is, sum of 4 numbers in an AP is 40 and product of their extremes is 91. Find the 4 numbers of the AP. So, in the last 3 questions, 3 numbers are there. We consider the 3 numbers as A minus B, A, A plus D. Here, for 4 numbers, if we consider like that, suppose if we take first term A, next term A plus D, one more term, previous term A minus B, either we have to write one more term here or we have to add one term here. Suppose if I write A plus 2D here, sum of the 4 number is 40. 4 numbers is 40. So, when we put plus sign is equal to 40, minus D and plus D will cancel. Again, we will get an equation in terms of A and D. That is, 4A plus 2D is equal to 40. We'll get. And product of the extremes when you get, right? Extremes means first and the last term. A minus D into A plus 2D when you multiply, you will get square. A square you will get, D square you will get. Calculation will be very lengthy. So, instead of doing this, whenever 4 terms in an AP, specially sum and product is given, we have to consider the four terms as A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. I will tell you how we can use these. Now maybe you are thinking, how can we take these four numbers, whether we are getting a common difference or not, to find out that. Well, this is the first term, second term. So we'll find out common difference, whether it is an AP or not, we will check it. D equals second term minus first term. Second term is A minus D minus first term is A minus 3D. Draw the bracket. Equals A minus D minus A, minus into minus plus 3D you will get. A and minus A will cancel. 3D minus D become 2D we will get. Here we will get D as 2D. Once again we will check. One more time we will find out D. Third term minus second term. Third term is A plus D minus A minus D. Second term. We'll open the bracket. A plus D minus A plus D. When you cancel it, D plus D you will get again 2D. So here the common difference is not D, it is 2D. Everywhere we will get common difference as 2D. So whenever four terms in an AP, especially sum and product is given, if we use these four terms, the sum will be very easy. So here, and if you change the order, you will not get the correct answer. Always follow the same way. First term should be A minus 3D. Second term is A minus D. Then A plus D. Then A plus 3D. So now we will write the sum is 40. A minus 3D plus A minus D plus A plus D is plus A plus 3D is equal to 40. Sum of four terms. Minus 3D plus 3. E and minus D plus D will cancel. A plus A plus A plus A is 4A equals 40 and A equals 40 by 4, 10. Now product of the extremes, 91. Extreme terms are A minus 3D product is into A plus 3D is equal to 91. So if you change the order, terms will become wrong. Now A square minus 3D the whole square. Don't forget to put the bracket equals 91. A square minus 9D square equals 91. Substitute the value of A. 10 square minus 9D square equals 91. 10 square is 100. Minus 91 equals 9D. 9D square. 9 equals 9D square. D square equals 9 by 9. 1. Now the four terms are. First term is A minus 3D. So A is 10. 10 minus 3 into 1. That is 10 minus 3, 7. The next term is A minus D. That is 10 minus 1, it is 9. Next term is A plus D. It is 10 plus 1, 11. Next term is A plus 3D. It is 10 plus 3 into 1 is equal to 13. So the four terms of the AP are 7, 9, 11, 13 and here you will get the common difference as 2. The next question is, in an AP there are four terms. Sum of the second and third term is 22 and product of the first and fourth term is 85. In the previous question, four terms are there. Sum of all the four terms is given in the first sentence. But here it is sum of only second and third term. So before starting the sum, we will write four terms. Which are the four terms? A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. Sum of second and third term is 22. So here second term is A minus D and third term is A plus D. Sum is 22. So cancel minus D plus D. 2A equals 22. A equals 22 by 2. 11. Now product of the first and the last term or product of the extremes is 85. So A minus 3D into A plus 3D is equal to 85. A square minus 3D the whole square equals 85. A value will substitute. 11 square minus 9D square equals 85. 121 minus 85 is equal to 9D square. 9D square equals 36. D square equals 36 by 9 4, D equals square root of 4, 2. Therefore, the four numbers are, first one is A minus 3D, 11 minus 3 into 2. It is 11 minus 6, 5. Next term is A minus D, 11 minus 2, 9. Next term is A plus D, 11 plus 2, 13. The fourth term is A plus 3D. It is 11 plus 3 into 2, 11 plus 6, 17. So the four terms are 5, 9, 13 and 17. What is the common difference? It is 4. The next question is, there are 5 terms in an EP. The sum of these terms is 55. And the fourth term is 5 more than the sum of the first two terms. Find the terms of the AP. There are 5 terms in an EP. The sum of these terms is 55. So there are 5 terms. Sum is 55. Sum of 5 terms is 55. We will write. And the fourth term is, fourth term is A4 is equals 5 more than, more means plus sign, more than the sum of the first two terms. Which are the two terms? A1 and A2. Sum of first two terms. Maybe you are thinking that why we have taken for 5 terms directly as 5. Why can't we take A minus 3D like that? So only for 3 terms we will take it as A minus D, A plus D when the sum and product is given. Easily we can cancel D and we will get the value of A. For 4 terms, A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D, if we take, directly we can cancel all the D's and we will get the value of D. But here, directly they said S5 is 55 and 4th term is 5 more than sum of the first 2 terms. Normal AP we can consider. Here S5 is equal to 55, we can write, use the formula and we can do. Or first 5 terms A plus D also we can do. So I will directly write S5. SN formula, 5 by 2 into 2A plus 5 minus 1 into D is equal to 55. From S5 I had written, SN formula used. 5 by 2 into 2A plus 4D is equal to 55. So here also if you want we can take one 2 common outside and cancel, or later we will do that. 2 we can cross multiply. 5 into 2A plus 4D is equal to, this 2 I will cross multiply, 2 into 55, 2a plus 4d is equal to 2 into 55 by 5, we will cancel 5 and 55, we will get 2a plus 4d is equal to 22. Throughout we will divide by 2, we will get a plus 2d is equal to 11. This is equation number 1. Now the second equation, the fourth term, A4. So how can we expand it? Once again, I'll write the second equation. Fourth term is 5 more than sum of first two terms. A4 is A plus 3D equals 5 plus A1 is A and A2 is A plus D. A plus 3D equals 5 plus 2A plus D. A plus 3D minus 2A minus D is equal to 5. Only if constant number will take it, will keep it in the right side. So we'll get minus A plus 2D is equal to 5. This is equation number 2. So how we have two equations. Once again I'll write the first equation, A plus 2D equals 11. Second equation, minus A plus 2D equals 5. So here I will add the two equations. Equation 1 plus equation 2 will add. A minus A when you add it will cancel. 2D plus 2D become 4D. 11 plus 5 is 16. D equals 16 by 4, 4. So we got D. Now we will find the value of A. Substitute in one of the equations. First equation I will write. A plus 2D equals 11. A plus 2 into 4 equals 11. A plus 8 equals 11. A equals 11 minus 8. So A is 3. Okay? So first term is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D and A plus 4D. that is A is 3, 3 plus 4, 3 plus 2 into 4, 3 plus 3 into 4, and 3 plus 4 into 4. 3, 7, 11, 15, and 19. These are the 5 terms of the AP. The next question is, in an AP, 6th term is 1 more than twice the 3rd term. The sum of the 4th and the 5th term is 5 times the 2nd term. Find the 10th term of the AP. In an AP, 6th term is 1 more than twice the 3rd term. 6th term, A6, is 1 more than twice the 3rd term. Twice means 2 into. 3rd term is A3. Let me expand this. A6 is A plus 5D equals 1 plus 2 into A3 can be written as A plus 2D. So A plus 5D is equal to 1 plus 2A plus 4D. A plus 5D minus 2A minus 4D is equal to 1. A minus 2A is minus A. 5D minus 4D is plus D is equal to 1. This is equation number 1. Next sentence is, the sum of the 4th and 5th term. Sum of 4th and 5th term. So, A4 plus A5 is 5 times the 2nd term. 5 times the 2nd term. 2nd term is A2. Same way, 5 times means 5 into A2. A4 is A plus 3D plus A plus 4D is equal to 5 into A plus D. Don't forget to draw the bracket because it's a binomial. 2A plus 7D is equal to 5A plus 5D. 2A plus 7D minus 5A minus 5D equals 0. Now right side no constant, we have to write 0. All the terms are taken to the left side. 2A minus 3A is minus 3, sorry, 2a minus 5a is minus 3a plus 2d is equal to 0. This is equation 2. Now you see, first equation is minus a plus b is 1, minus 3a plus 2d equals 0 is the second equation. In these two equations, coefficients for a or coefficients of b are not equal. So we will multiply the first equation by either 3 or by 2. I'll multiply the first equation by 3 so that minus 3a plus 3d is equal to 3 we will get, first equation. Next equation as it is we will write minus 3a plus 2d equal 0. So as the sign is same, we will subtract the equation, equation 1 minus 2. While subtracting we have to change the sign. So minus 3a plus 3 will cancel, 3d minus 2d become d, 3 minus 0 is 3, d is 3. Now we'll write one of the equation, minus a plus d is equal to 1, minus a plus 3 equals 1, minus a equals 1 minus 3, minus a equals minus 2, and a is equal to 2. Cancel the side. So we have a and d. Now what we have to find out is, find the 10th term of the AP. A10, 10th term. A10 equals a plus 9d equals 2 plus 9 into 3, 2 plus 27 equals 29. I hope you all understood these different sums which we solved today. Thank you, children.